Yes, good afternoon. I hope I am clearly audible now, right?
Okay. Just a second. Okay. So I have given you the question answers for the entire glimpses of India, and I told you that I will not give separate portions, but I will give the entire portion as it itself is lesson 7. Okay. Now is it okay? Yes. So as it is lesson 7, so I have to include all the three parts in one section, and that's why this PDF is created, and I have sent it in the Google Classroom. Also, if you notice that we teachers have also provided the assignment worksheets that you will be solving during the pujas, and you will be submitting that within 31st of October. Okay, so you will be submitting that, and the question answers that are there, you will find it similar after I complete this. So I would suggest that until and unless I complete this, if you have any questions regarding Baker from Goa, Krug, or any question from a tea from Assam, you can ask while within the class. But if you have anything else, if you discuss anything else useless which is not related to the class, if you start say hi, hello to your friends, then I am going to permanently shut your chat options. Hope you are clear with that. Relevant portions that are necessary for the studying will only be discussed. Rest of the things, no discussion for that. Okay. I have opened the book also. Okay. I have opened the book also for you. So anytime we can refer the book. So the first thing we gave is the introduction to the lesson. The thing is divided in this part, that it is first as the introduction part, then is the summary part, then is the word meanings. I have given you the word meanings because most of you were asking me the word meanings while the class was going on. So the word meanings are provided. So I'll start with a baker from Goa. So what I have given is, it is the introduction. A baker from Goa revolves around the relevance of a baker in the Goan culture, which dates back to the time when Portuguese ruled over the city of Goa. So it is the time of the Portuguese, when Portuguese ruled over the city. The Portuguese may left, but the bread makers continue to have an inevitable stature. In this story, the author recalls his childhood days and their excitement to seeing the baker. So this is all the story all about. We have read that on the previous day's class. They were enthusiastic to point that they would run to him as soon as they woke up without even brushing their teeth. Now, most of you can ask me that what is the relevance of this introduction and summary. This relevance of introduction and summary is that it will help you to construct the answers. Now, how will it help? If you follow the first part, see it is written students are advised to write all those notes in their English literature copy. Now, if you only write these things in the copy, then only it is possible to write answers on your own. In the assignment worksheets, I have mentioned that you must write the answers on your own as far as practicable, apart from the notes that I have given. So there might be some questions which are similar to the notes that I provided, but I would expect that you will write the answers on your own. That will help you to give an answers in an effective way in the exam.
So that is expected from you. Okay, okay.
Yes, inside everything comes from inside. The NCERT questions that I always make you write, these things need to be written because this is the way how the answer should be written. So this is just a format. For class 10 and class 12, actually we can't predict what questions will come in both. That is the basic thing. So both for class 10 and class 12, we have to prepare in this way only. Okay. Like the summary, we have to read the introductions, we have to know the word meanings and phrases. In this way we will prepare. Okay. So the glimpses of India, it starts from the summary. The lesson begins with how narrator's elders often recall the time when Goa was under the rule of the Portuguese. They talk how important of the bakers still maintained in the villages even after the Portuguese left. So the bakery still is there in Portuguese bakery is still there in Goa. Okay. They are known as pedas in Goa. So the bakers are known as pedas in Goa. The mixers, molders and their time tested furnace continue to serve the people of Goa with their famous bread loaves. So they produce the famous bread loaves. It is possible that the original ones may not exist, but their profession is being continued by their sons. So the original bakers do not exist, okay, the Portuguese, but their sons continued their professions. So the thud of their bamboo stick can still be heard in some parts of the village. I explained you, some of you asked me what is the important means thud of the stick. So this is how the sound is being produced. That would say that the baker has arrived. Okay. The same jingling thud would make the narrator and its friends during their childhood days, who would go running to him without brushing or washing their mouth properly. Okay. So they would rush without brushing or washing their mouth. It was the maid servant of the house who collected the loaves while children sorted out the bread bangles for themselves. So the bread bangles almost look like the rings of bread. Okay. Bakery products have importance in the culture and traditions of Goa. So bakery products are important for the culture of Goa. The bowl of sweet bread is a part of marriage gifts. Cakes, bolenhas or coconut cookies are eaten at every festival, and the lady of the house prepares sandwiches at the daughter's engagement. Earlier bakers wore a unique frock of knee length known as kabai, but during the narrator's childhood days they wore a shirt and trousers of length slightly shorter than the usual ones. They generally collect their bills at the end of every month. So they have a keeping of accounts, system of keeping the accounts basically. Bakery has continued to be a profitable profession, managing to keep their families joyous and prosperous. So this is what the bakers of Goa is. I provided the word meanings. Okay, they have phrases also. Okay. So reminiscing nostalgically means thinking fondly of the past. Loaves means plural of loaf. It is a bread that is shaped yes in the world they are writing their income also. Okay. So bread that is shaped and baked in a single piece and can be sliced for eating. Vanished means disappeared suddenly and completely, that you know. Molders means a person who molds dough into a shape. And furnaces is, this is the oven like thing, okay, of enclosed structure which materials can be heated to a very high temperature. So these are ovens, we can say. Extinguished means ceased fire. Cause a fire to cease to burn. Heralding means announcing. Pedar. This pedar is a word for baker in Portuguese language. Staff means stick. Rebuke means an expression of disapproval or a scolding, we can say. Fragrance means a pleasant sweet smell. Parapet. This is a railing, a low protective wall. Bangles means here it refers to the bread in the shape of a bangle called cancone. Feast means a large meal, typically of a celebrity one. And Ballenhus is another name of coconut cookies. So coconut cookies are known as Ballenhus. Coconut biscuit has been a famous part of the bakery. Each and every baker, almost in every part, wherever in India, you will find the coconut cookies being sold by the bakers. Okay, so these are the question answers. These are basically the question answers that I they are in the NCERT book. But let me tell you that this baker from Goa and Coorg only have the NCERT questions. But a tea from Assam, the questions are not there in the NCERT. Some questions are inside the book. Okay, so only these two portions, part 1 and part 2, have the NCERT questions. Okay, so the first question is, what are the elders in Goa nostalgic about, means reminiscing about that thing, that part. Okay, so it means that the narrator often finds his elder thinking about those good old days and telling them about the famous breads that date back to the time when Portuguese ruled over Goa. They ponder over the past and tell them that though the Portuguese have left Goa, but the bakers still exist, if not the original ones, their legacy is being continued by the sons. So nostalgic means thinking about the past. So what are they thinking about the past? About the good old days when the Portuguese ruled over Goa. Okay. Is bread making still popular in Goa? How do you know? So how do we know that bread making is still popular in Goa? Yes, bread making is still popular in the city of Goa. It is evident from the existence of the time-tested furnace, mixer and molders. Okay. The legacy of bakers is being continued by their sons. You will find a bakery in every Goan village as bread is an important part of the Goan culture. So in those parts, okay, bread is an important part of the culture. What is the baker called? The baker is referred to as Peder in the city of Goa. This is a 1-mark question. Okay, another thing, 1-mark question can be also of this length. Okay. 1-mark question can also be of 2 or 3 sentences. Keep this in mind. Don't write just 1 mark means 1 mark. Okay, it might be 1 mark also, it might be 2 or 3 sentences also. Especially for the assignment that I gave. Okay, when would the baker come every day? Why did the children run to meet him? So the baker would come twice every day during the narrator's childhood days. Once in the morning to deliver the loaves of bread, and secondly in the evening in his return after selling his stock. The children would go running to take him to the take bread, special bread bangles he had made for them. You can write this type of answers as if this is a written in simple sentences. You can write this on your own if you wish to continue. Rather, you should write on your own. Okay. What did the bakers wear in the Portuguese days and when the author was young? So in the Portuguese days, the bakers wore a unique knee-length frock dress, typically known as kabai. And when the author was young, in the narrator's childhood day, he has seen them wearing shirts and shorter than usual pants. Okay, so the shirts were shorter than the pants, so it is a kind of gown type of thing. Who invites the comment, he is dressed like a peder, why? So here invite means take. Invite means take the comment. In what we do in case of invitation, we call somebody. Okay, we call somebody, isn't it? So during the narrator's childhood days, the bakers had a peculiar dress. They wore shirts and shorter than usual pants. Thus, if someone is seen wearing pants of this much length, they invite the comment, means they call the comment, he is dressed like a peder. Okay. Yes, this where you are saying. Where were the monthly accounts of the baker recorded? The monthly accounts of the baker were recorded on some wall with a pencil. What does a jackfruit-like appearance means? So jackfruit-like appearance means a well-built or plump physique, similar to a jackfruit, means he's a very fat man. I said already in the class, jackfruit-like appearance means he's extremely fat. In those days, bakers had plump physique because baking was a profitable profession. His family and servants never starved and were prosperous. So the baker's family never starved and they were very prosperous. Yes. So is bread an important part of Goan life? How do you know this? So bread is an important part of the Goan culture and it is evident from its presence at every important occasion. From sweets, breads at marriages to sandwiches in the engagement parties and cakes and bolinhas at the Christmas as well as other occasions makes the presence of a baker in every village very essential. So these were the 9 questions and these were the word meanings. I have not given all the word meanings here that were there in the book, but the meanings that are there in the book, you can also read them. You will also read them and you will also read these notes. So in this way it has been written. So see, this is part 1. Just see, this is part 1, a baker from Goa. Like in the book, I have mentioned only. In the book it is also written part 2, Coorg, and I have also mentioned Coorg part 2. Similarly, part 3 is in this way. Tea from Assam. Okay, so all these have more than 15 word meanings and phrases which will help you to understand the text. Okay, so Coorg. So it is in the introduction goes like this. The lesson gives us a beautiful insight of the smallest district of Karnataka and its people. So this is the smallest district of Karnataka and its people. The place has an amazing weather throughout the year with enough rain during the monsoon season. The people of Coorg are known to be one of the bravest and they are the warrior class basically. Coffee is the main crop grown in this region. A variety of animals can be found here while the place is surrounded by very beautiful Brahmagiri hills, the islands and Tibetan settlements. So various hills, islands, settlements make this place very beautiful and this is known for the very important thing which is the coffee plantation. Okay, glimpses of India. This is the Coorg and this is the summary of Coorg. So it is a description of a hill station. Previously it was a Goan culture, a small village in Goa. Now this is Karnataka and then we will move to Assam. Okay, so west, south and east, these three are being explained as the glimpse of India. There are many glimpses of India but these are the important ones that the CBS has decided. Okay, so the summary goes like this. The writer describes the hill station of Coorg located in the Western Ghats. So where is Coorg located? In the Western Ghats in the state of Karnataka. It is located midway between Bangalore and Mangalore. The suitable time to visit Coorg is September to March. The place is famous for coffee plantations and spices. There are abundant rainforests which cover 30% of the area. It will be Bengaluru probably now. The spelling is Bengaluru. Okay. The Coorgi men are brave warriors who are permitted to keep firearms without a license due to their trustworthiness. The women of Coorg are pretty. Coorg is also known as Kodavu or the Kodavas, though they are Hindu by religion, but their customs differ from those mainstream Hindus. They marry within their community. Cordovas are said to be of Greek or Arabic descent. Some soldiers of Alexander's army settled there. Also, as ethnic dresses of Cordovas, kufia is similar to the Arab garment kufia. It is said that it may be the ancestor where the Arabs or Kurds. So the way they are dressing, though they are Greek or Arabic descent, okay, they came from Greek or Arabia, but they still settle there. It is believed that some soldiers of Alexander's army still settle there. And the dress, it is similar to the Arabic garment, okay, it is similar almost to the Arabic garment, which is known as kufia. And it is said that maybe their ancestors were Arab or Kurds, that's why they still wore that type of dress. See how an Arabian culture actually came to India and we still adopt their culture. This is what India is known for. We adapted others' cultures and we made it in our own way. We adapted others' culture and we made it in our own way. Apart from having our own style, we could say that we won't wear this, we won't wear that, but no, we adapted their cultures also. Okay, the river Kaveri originates from Kurk. The fish named Mahshe is found in the river. Many animals are birds, like kingfisher, langurs, squirrels and elephants can be spotted along the river. Tourists relax in the serene atmosphere and also enjoy adventure sports like river rafting, canoeing, rappelling, mountain biking, rock climbing and trekking. So while trekking, these type of adventure sports are enjoyed by the tourists, like rafting, river rafting, canoeing. Canoe is a kind of boat, rappelling, mountain biking, rock climbing, trekking. Okay, while trekking on the nature trails, animals like macaws, malabar, squirrels, langurs and slender lorries can be spotted on the trees. These type of animals can be spotted on the trees. The major tourist attractions are Brahmagiri Hills, Nisargdham Island and Bailakuppe Tibetan settlements. Kurk gives visitors a feel of India's diverse culture. So Kurk gives visitors feel of India's diverse cultures. So the phrases and word meanings are also given. Drifted from means being carried along gently by here. Martial means having to do with ward. Canopies, so these roof like coverings made on trees that form a shelter. Prime means best. Invigorating, US asking, okay, this is strong, okay, so a strong smell comes, okay, that invigorating smell of coffee. Okay, mainstream, a tradition which most people follow. Tales of valor means stories of courage and bravery, usually in a war, so these are tales of valor. Then comes the descent. Descent means the origin. Then comes most decorated, having received maximum number of awards for bravery in a war. So these meanings, whatever is given here, it is on the basis of the text. If you find the dictionary, you might find different meanings of different words, and you might say that these words are not matching with the words that I have given. Actually, these are relevant from the text only. So what is meant in the text, that is being told here. Okay. Mischief means playful behavior. Ripple effect means a small wave. Ripple effect means a small wave or series of waves on the surface of water, especially as caused by a slight breeze or an object dropping into it. So it is a series of waves on a water that is known as ripple effect. Mahouts is a person who works with, rides and tends an elephant, that is known as mahout, elephant keeper basically. Okay. Laid back means relaxed, not in a hurry. Rafting here is a kind of sports, traveling in a river in raft, a floating platform made by tying planks together. Okay. Canoeing means traveling in a river canoe, a large narrow boat where one or two people can sit. Rappelling means going down a cliff by sliding down a rope, that is known as rappelling. Then comes trails, means path created by walking, so this is known as trails. So these are the question answers. Enter is not given. Okay. So where is Coorg? So Coorg is the smallest district of Karnataka and is located somewhere between Mysore and the coastal city of Mangalore. So it is located somewhere between Mysore and the coastal city of Mangalore. What is the story about Kodavu people's descent? So what is the story? This is a 2-mark question basically. So these are the stories. It is said that the Kodavas are of either Greek or Arabic descent. Basically the people of Coorg. According to one story, a part of Alexander's army could not return to its homeland and so they settled there. As a traditional dress of Kodavas, kufia is similar to the dress of the Arabs and Kurds. The kufia, it is said that probably the Kodavas are descendants of Arabs. What are some things you know about? Then it comes as 1, 2, 3, in this way it comes. The people of Coorg. So, the people of Coorg, we are writing this in this way only. So, the way you should write in the copy, it is designed in that way only. So, there are many questions like people of Coorg, the main crop of Coorg, the sports it offered to the tourists, the animals that you are likely to see in Coorg, the distance from Bangalore and how to get there. So we will come one by one. So first comes the people of Coorg. So the people of Coorg are known to be descendants of Greeks or Arabs. So this same type of questions answer is there. This is because their dressing style. They are independent and ferocious. Means they can attack at any time. They are the bravest soldiers in the Indian army. At the same time, they are welcoming and they are known for their hospitality. They have married amongst their locals and their culture is very different from what is seen in the mainstream Hindus. Next comes, what is the main crop of Coorg? The coffee is the main crop of Coorg during the monsoon season when the weather is pleasant. Yes. Weather is pleasant and the wind is blowing, it carries it with the fragrance of coffee. Coffee estates with colonial bungalows are abundant and even provide homestays for visitors to experience the Coorgi way of life. Then it comes the sports it offers to the tourists. A variety of high energy adventure activities are offered to tourists like river rafting, canoeing, rappelling, rock climbing and mountain biking. So these are the sports activities that are offered to the tourist. So trekking is also one of the famous activities, one of them. Then the animals we see from Coorg. Fishes like marsh are found in the waters of the river Kaveri. Birds like kingfisher and other animals like squirrels, langurs, butterflies, bees accompany you in this area. While the you have to remember all this, okay, in the exam. While the wild elephants can be seen enjoying in the bathing in the rivers, if you are on a trek, macaws, malabar squirrels, langurs and slender loris can be spotted on trees. So these you have to remember. Then the distance from Bangalore. This is in the last part of the lesson when I stopped there and I explained that also. So Coorg is at a distance of 260 kilometers from Bangalore. The nearest airports are Mangalore 135 km and Bangalore 260 km. There are flights to Mangalore from Mumbai and to Bangalore from Ahmedabad, Chennai, Delhi and Goa, Hyderabad, Kochi, Kolkata, Mumbai and Pune. Yes, I told to learn it. Same thing is being written here. See, the answers is also written in that way. The nearest railways are at Mysore, Mangalore and Hassan. There are two routes of Coach from Bangalore. Both are almost of the same distance, around 250 to 260 km. The route via Mysore is the most frequented one. The other route is via Nilamangal, Koyangal and Chennaraya Patna. Chennaraya Patna. Okay. So this is another part. This is all about the Coorg. And we will quickly move on to another part, which is the T from Assam. T from Assam is another important part, but the question and answers are not there in the book. Okay, so I have collected it. Okay, very small questions are there. See, so this is a baker from Goa. I'm referring to the book now. Okay, so these are the thinking about language. It started with thinking about language. Speaking and writing. And the lesson ends. See. So, we will start discussing with the introduction. So the lesson is about two friends, Pranjal and Rajveer, who are traveling to Pranjal's hometown, Assam, for summer vacation. Assam is known for the tea country. It has the largest concentration of plantations in the world. During their journey, they discuss about the various legends that are known to have discovered tea. The story tells us about the popularity of tea as beverage, and we will see how Rajveer is do a lot of research, while Pranjal staying there doesn't seem interested in at all, because for him it is just like any other thing. So the summary goes like, the story revolves around the infamous privilege tea telling and discovery. Okay, where two friends Pranjal and Rajveer set out to go to Assam, Pranjal's hometown, when a tea vendor asks them if they like to have some freshly made tea. So they buy two, almost every other person in their compartment. From there the journey begins, his detective book, while Rajveer decides to enjoy the scenic beauty. This is one you should do when you travel. You should not read, especially when you are traveling to a tea estate and you have not seen anything. You must enjoy the beauty instead of reading any or doing useless stuff. When to read a detective book? When you are already acquainted to the place, then you should read books, then you should do things. Okay. So they buy two cups, joining almost every other person in the compartment. From there the journey begins, and Pranjal starts reading his detective books, while Rajveer decides to enjoy the scenic beauty. So there were soft green paddy fields followed by tea bushes. Rajveer is very excited on seeing such large plantations of tea, but Pranjal is unable to match the same level because he was born and brought up in Assam, famously known as the tea country. So he cannot enjoy that. He was born and brought up there. So visiting there for the first time, Rajveer did a lot of study about how tea was discovered and that it dates back to 27,000 BC. Okay, so that scenic beauty means scenery it looks like a scenery. You draw scenery, okay? So that scenery is known as scenic beauty. So it dates back to 27,000 BC. Actually, this dates 27,000 BC. Though Assam, this region, is known for the tea. Okay. Yes. So Assam is known for the tea country because in India, for the first time in the 17th or 16th century, some foreigner first documented that a tea plant is found in Assam only. That is documented in the history of tea. So Assam was the state from where the tea was found for the first time in India. Okay. But Pranjal is unable. Okay. So it dates back to 27,000 BC. According to what he read, it was first consumed in China and it reached to Europe in the 16th century, where it was most popular for its medicinal property. That is known. There are numerous stories about how it was discovered, one of a Chinese emperor and about a Buddhist monk. So there are Chinese emperor, how the Chinese emperor discovered it, how the Buddhist monk said it. So there are many stories. So the former liked the taste of it, while the latter used to get rid of the sleep. As they were having this discussion, they reached the destination where Pranjal's parents had come to receive them and take them to their tea garden. On their way, they passed a cattle bridge and gave way to a truck filled with tea leaves, which drew their attention to the fact that it was the second sprouting season. Rajveer indeed did a lot of study before coming, which impressed Pranjal's father, and he intended to learn a lot more. So this is what you should do. Okay, whenever you eat anything, you must know the habit of knowing its history. Why we are eating that, what we are eating, why is it we are eating, how it came. Okay. So various whatever food we eat, okay, unknowingly we don't know that we are eating almost all parts of food from every part of the world. We are unknowingly eating our food. We must know the history of it also. So this is just a story telling the history. So the word meanings are, various Indian word meanings are given, like chai means tea, garam means hot, saab means sahib or sir. Then the steaming means extremely hot, because these are Indian words, so it is italicized. Okay. Exclaim means cry out suddenly in surprise. Paddy fields means a field where rice is grown. Backdrop means lie or behind or beyond, serve as a background too. As far as I could see means for a long distance, until something is so far away, small, it cannot be seen anymore. Then comes the dwarfing. Dwarfing means cause to seem small or insignificant in comparison. Then comes sturdy means strong. Then comes amidst means in the middle of. Then comes billowing. Billowing means moving or flowing outwards. Then comes the concentration means cluster. Then comes the ascetic means characterized by severe self-discipline and abstention from all forms of indulgence, typically for religious reasons. Then comes banished means get rid of. Then comes clattered means loud noise made by train brakes. Then comes weed means change direction. Then comes gravel means small rounded stones often mixed with sand. Then comes prune means cut away from a tree. Then comes sprouting period means when a plant sends out new growth, second harvest of the tea leaves in a season. That is known as sprouting period. Okay, so these are the questions, some extra questions within the lesson. So what excited Rajveer and why did Pranjal not share his excitement? So the sight of the vast sea of lush green tea bushes coupled with tall sturdy trees excited Rajveer. Pranjal did not share Rajveer's excitement, as he had been born and brought up on the tea plantation. Then what legends are associated with the origin of tea? So that there was once a Chinese emperor who, so the origins are, legends are, number A, there was once a Chinese emperor who always boiled water before drinking it. One day a few leaves
of twigs burning under the pot fell into the water, which gave it a delicious flavor. It is said that they were tea leaves. Okay, it will be tea leaves, right? Tea leaves. Then Bodhidharma, an ancient Buddhist ascetic, cut off his eyelids because he felt sleepy during the meditations. 10 tea plants grew out of the eyelids. The leaves of these plants, when put in hot water, drunk, vanished sleep. So that is the thing. Then why did Rajveer feel that the view outside the window was magnificent? Rajveer had seen such beautiful greenery in his life. He was fascinated to see tea gardens and the wooden hills, so it called it a magnificent view. The tea pluckers looked like dolls to him. Then comes, why does Rajveer call the workers like figures? So the tea pluckers were the local women. They had covered themselves with clothes from top to bottom. They looked like moving dolls. Rajveer called them doll-like figures. They looked really very pretty. So why was Pranjal not excited on seeing the tea garden? It is obvious. As Pranjal was born and brought up in Assam, he had been watching the tea garden since his childhood. There was nothing new for him. So he was not excited on seeing the tea gardens. What is the Chinese legend about the discovery of tea? Almost the same answer. According to a Chinese legend, a Chinese emperor discovered tea accidentally. He used to boil water before drinking it. One day, few leaves of some twigs burning inside the pot fell into the water, giving it a delicious flavor. It is said that they were tea leaves. Then what is the Indian legend about discovery of tea? According to Indian legend, Bodhidharma, an ancient Buddhist ascetic, cut off his eyelids because he felt very sleepy during meditation. 10 tea plants grew out of his eyelids. The leaves of these plants, when put into hot water and drunk, vanished sleep. So how are tea pluckers different from the other farmers and or laborers on the farms? How are they different? So the tea pluckers were different from other workers on the farm. They had bamboo baskets on their back. They were wearing plastic clothes. They looked like moving dolls. And which tea is considered the best tea? Why? So the tea prepared from the second flush on sprouting period, which begins on the month of May and lasts till the end of July, is considered to be the best tea. It is the best one because it is prepared from the new leaves. So these were the question answers, the extra question answers that were set from the lesson. First, write these question answers in the copy. Then only start attempting the English worksheet that is given in the Google Classroom. Okay, both are given. Animals question answers are also given. So the worksheets that I gave for the puja assignment is from the both the lessons. Also, a grammar portion is there and a writing portion is there, which you can write already, I believe. Okay, so nothing would be problematic in case of solving the assignment. You have to solve this within 31st of October, so be prepared with that. Okay. So we are ending the class here. Start writing these question answers in the copy along with the introduction, summary, word meanings and question answers. Then start attempting. Okay, bye. I'm closing the video now.